Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. We welcome back. It's the Oracle of Chinem Kutu, and we are now going to look at applications, and we are looking at question 2, which will show the application of the quotient and the chain rule. And this is the question that I got from Smedley and Wiseman, the textbook for pure mathematics. And it says it was given as example 9 in some differentiation chapter. Find the equation of the tangent and the normal to the curve y is equal to ln bracket x minus 1 over x plus 1 at the point P where x is equal to 3. So now here we are moving from just an understanding and application of concepts to the application of those concepts to real the solutions, real questions. So what we want is to find the equation of the tangent and the normal to the curve at point P. That is our problem. But then, for us to get to the solution of that problem, we have to do a lot more than just going straight to the solution. So this question is not a short question. It is a very long question. It appears short in terms of the space that it occupies on the board, but in actual effect, it is testing quite a number of concepts that you should be able to remember. So they say find the equation of the tangent and the normal. First, we need to know what is the tangent, what is the normal. The tangent to a curve or to a point at a given point on the curve is the line that just touches the curve at that point, and it's a straight line. So immediately we say it's a straight line. We know that the equation of a straight line is given by y is equal to mx plus c, where m is the gradient of the line and c is the y-intercept of that line. And the y-intercept is the value of y at the point where x is equal to 0. So then the next thing that we need to understand is what is the normal. The normal is the line that crosses the tangent at the point of tangency at 90 degrees to the tangent. So in other words, the normal is also a line, and therefore its equation follows the same general principle of the equation of a line, which is y is equal to mx plus c, m is the gradient, and c is the intercept. So then the curve is given by a natural logarithm function, ln x minus 1 over x plus 1, and the base of that logarithmic function is the natural number e, and so these are different concepts that we should bear in mind for us to get to the final solution. So you are told that it's at the point P where x is equal to 3. So in other words, I recommend that in any question that you are given, find out the simpler things that you can get first before you start complicating your life. You will pick up a few marks for getting the right things out of the way. So here we know that y is equal to ln x minus 1 over x plus 1, and at P x is equal to 3, so we can get the value of y at point P. So that would be our starting point. So we can say at P, where x is equal to 3, we can find the value of y by substituting x with 3 in the function y. So therefore y is equal to ln 3 minus 1 over 3 plus 1, and we then say y is equal to ln of 2 over 4, and that gives us y is equal to ln of half. And since we are dividing 1 by 2, y is equal to ln of 1 minus ln of 2. And we know that ln of 1, or the logarithm of any to any base of 1, the logarithm of 1 to any base is equal to 0. Because basically the logarithm is an exponent, and if you raise any power, any variable to the power of 0, you will get 1. So therefore, y at p is equal to minus ln of 2. So therefore we can say y is equal to minus ln of 2, and we call that our equation 1. So then once we find our equation 1 there, the next step, finding the gradient of the tangent at P, the point of tangents. Where x is equal to 3 and y is equal to minus ln of 2. So now, at the point of tangents, which is where we said is the place where a line just touches the curve, that means that the gradient of the tangent at the point of tangents coincides with the gradient of the curve. So that means the gradient of the curve and the gradient of the tangent at the point of tangency is exactly the same. So then we are going to differentiate the curve in order to get the gradient of the curve at the point of tangency, and we equate that to the gradient of the tangent. So there, here is now where we need the quotient rule, where we realize that x minus 1 over x plus 1 is basically u divided by v, and we will apply the chain rule, the quotient rule, as well as the differential of a logarithm. So in the previous presentation, we said this one was the product rule, of differentiation. Now the quotient rule. Says if y is equal to u over v, and u and v are both functions of x, then dy dx is equal to v du dx minus u dv dx all over v squared. And notice I have given first precedence to v by differentiating du dx first, and always write it that way. Otherwise, if you flip it, you end up with the wrong sign but the correct solution. Or this is simply written as v u prime plus u minus, not plus, this is not the product rule, minus u v prime all over v squared. So we now can put a demarcating line there, and find the gradient of the curve at point B. So we say dy dx using that function there equals to, first we differentiate the log, which is 1 over bracket x minus 1 over x plus 1 close bracket, and then using the chain rule we differentiate what is inside the bracket, and we realize that what is inside the bracket is quotient. We then apply the quotient rule where we say our u is x minus 1 and our v is x plus 1. So we say x plus 1 multiplied by d dx of x minus 1. That gives us 1 mod minus this whole complex, we can put it in the square bracket, minus our u is x minus 1. So we say x minus 1 multiplied by the d dx of x plus 1, which is times 1, and we close our square brackets. So then here, because we are dividing with a fraction, we invert. So dy dx is equal to x plus 1 over x minus 1 times bracket, we solve that. This gives us x plus 1 minus x plus 1. Then when you remove the brackets, we multiply everything that is in the close the brackets by minus 1, and we close there. And then we say dy dx equals to this is x plus 1 over x minus 1 times, this becomes x minus x. Yeah, there again, here we left out a very important aspect of the quotient rule. We need to extend that, divide that by our v squared, which is x plus 1 to the power 2, extend our close the brackets there. So here we are still having our x plus 1 squared, and so we can actually realize that this can be cancelled out, and here we cancel out the 2. So we are then left with x minus x is 0, 1 plus 1 is 2, so we are then left with 2 over x plus 1, and this is no longer there because we cancelled it out at that point. So this gives us 1. If you make the mistake of not following through the formula itself and forget the x plus 1 to the power 2, you are going to have a torrid time coming up to the correct differential, the correct gradient. So here we can now say dy dx is equal to 2 over, you can realize that this is x minus 1 times x plus 1, that gives you x squared minus x plus x minus 1, and it is it gives you the difference of 2 squares. So we have x squared minus 1. And so at P, where x is equal to 3, the gradient of the tangent equals to 2/9 - 1, which is equal to 2/8, and that is equal to 1/4. And then once you say that the gradient of tangent is 1/4, the relationship between the gradient of the tangent and that of the normal is that they are negative reciprocals of each other. In other words, if you multiply the gradient of the tangent and the gradient of the normal, they are going to give you minus 1. So if we call our gradient of the tangent 1/4, that means if we say g tangent times g normal is equal to minus 1. Therefore, the gradient of the normal times 1 over 4 is equal to minus 1, where 1 over 4 is the gradient of the tangent. So therefore, the gradient of the normal equals 2 minus 4. So we can say this is 2, this is 3. Now we want to find the equations. So we can draw there and say that general equation of the line is y is equal to mx plus c, where m is the gradient of the line and c is the intercept. Therefore, equation of the equation of the tangent is y is equal to the gradient of the tangent is 1 over 4 x plus c, and then we know that at P, where x is equal to 3 and y is equal to minus ln of 2, we can get the value of C by substituting or by substitution. So we will have minus ln of 2 equals to 3, which is the value of x, over 4 plus c, and therefore c equals to minus 3 over 4 minus ln of 2. And therefore, y equals to 1 over 4 x minus 3 over 4 minus ln of 2. And that gives you the equation of the tangent. Now to get the equation of the normal, we do the same. trick. So we have y is equal to minus 4x, that is the gradient of the normal, plus c, and therefore c is equal to minus 4. So to get c, we do the same substitution as we did above. So we say y is minus ln of 2 equals 2 minus 12 plus c, x is 3. So therefore c is equal to 12 minus ln of 2. And therefore, y is equal to minus 4x plus 12 minus ln of 2. And that is the equation of the normal. So this is the equation of the normal. And the whole question is now done. The final solutions of what we were needed to show has been shown. The equation of the tangent, the equation of the normal. So basically, that's it. You have seen the application of the quotient rule, and always remember that it's v squared beneath there. Otherwise, you run into trouble if you forget to include v squared. So we are done. Please watch our videos, share with friends, and make comments. Let us discuss. If you have got any more questions concerning this, you can send them on my platform, WhatsApp platform, or 08144 11390, internationally plus 27 8144 11390, and thank you.